something to the works of art created here. It makes them come true.
My mom gave me this old light switch.
The clicker.
Alice is being kept in a dark prison. I need to find Cynthia Weaver to fix this.
Your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
Guess we didn't get to wait, huh?
Crowd from the neighboring counties. Naturally, we hope to break the record set by last year's Moose Fest in our neighboring town, Watery. Ladies and gentlemen, some people have asked me, what's the big deal about Deer Fest? And I think that this sums it up. It's about friendship and community. We've got a great party coming up. Let's try to hold it in tomorrow. Get through the night in one piece, all right?
Someone will come for it when the time is right. Thomas said so. He wrote it. The key is insurance. It's my job to keep it safe. Safe in the light. Or is it a light?
Hello.
All the manuscript pages were gone. The FBI agent had taken them.
I think my tongue just took a crap in my mouth. Oh, wait, we're in jail now? Al, this is not good.
That about sums it up.
Oh, I am never drinking.
I need to talk to Weaver. She's the one in the song, the Lady of the Light.
What, the crazy lady? Ugh, whatever you
what
say, Al,
kind of
but we're
you
stuck
playing
here.
Nightingale? You haven't
gonna...
even interviewed Wake.
I had some reading to do first, Sheriff. And let me tell you, it was an interesting read. Well, I've got you now, Raymond Chandler. It's all here. All the evidence, including conspiracy to murder a federal agent. There's no way you're walking out of here. You hear me in there, Brett Easton Ellis? Huh?
Agent Nightingale, I want to talk to your superior.
Well, we all want things, Sheriff. I wanted my... Look, that's not possible right now.
Agent Nightingale, I insist.
Wake, what's wrong?
Lady, are you stupid? It's a trick. It's an obvious trick.
Okay, I've had enough of this crap. Wake, I'm gonna trust you with this.
You're joking.
Agent Nightingale, your opinion would matter more if you were sober and if I actually believed you were here on official business.
Whoa! Get back in the cell, Stephen King. The only way you're leaving this place is over my dead...
Wait a minute. I know
Oh my God!
Light. We need light. It's the only way to fight this thing.
In my office. I've got your things there. Follow me.
Oh, man. We're sitting ducks with the lights out.
Nightingale tried to make sense of the manuscript. It was disjointed and strange. He didn't understand half of it, but it all rang true. Impossibly true. He took out his hip flask when he reached the page that described how he reached the page that made him take out his hip flask. It wasn't the booze that made his mind reel.
And another page.
Nightingale felt the situation veering out of his control, but the gun at least felt steady in his hands. He was ready to fire, resolved that he would let this happen over his dead body. And yet he hesitated. He had seen this moment before, read it in the page. He was transfixed by the deja vu and the horror that he was a character in a story someone had written. Then the monstrous presence burst in behind him and dragged him into the night.
Okay, let's go, lady. Let there be light.
Need to know.
They can be hurt in the light, only in the light, and I need to find Cynthia Weaver.
She can help me stop this.
Light. Check. Cynthia. Pretty quickly in the rescue chopper. Come on, let's get back to your friend. Wheeler, I need you to stay here.
What? No!
We're going to fetch our friend. Warned about this, and I need your help.
Well, okay.
Here's a list of people and phone numbers. I need you to call them and tell them you have a message from me. Night Springs, okay? They'll know what to do.
Night Springs? Like the TV show? Gotcha. Oh, hey, that radio guy is on the list. Maine. Who's Frank Breaker? He related to you?
My dad.
Hey, is this like a secret society?
Can you do this? You'll be safe here. The backup power's on. These guys need to be alerted, just in case we don't
nice butt.
You'll come back for me, though, right?
As soon as we get the chopper ready. Thanks, Wheeler. I owe you one. Okay, let's go, Wake. Through the back.
Hangover wants a pizza.
Through the back, huh? Sure, we can go through the back. Let's get some flares first. Okay. Let's go.
Oh, hell. Whatever took Nightingale must have broken the gate controls. We can't reach the gate's control box from here. We need to get to the other side over the rooftop.
I'll go. I'll open the gate for you once I'm across. You stay here in the light and cover me, Sheriff, okay?
Are you sure? Okay then, but hurry.
I see a ladder.
Focus. I needed to reach the rooftop to get to the other side of the broken gate.
Yeah, I know where I'm supposed to be going already. I must run right into it. Or what? Up we climb to the sky. More crap. Flare, flare. Up we go. Okay. Come on, what the heck, man?
Sheriff, your password. Night Springs? What's that all about?
It's a stupid joke we have. That Bright Falls is the original inspiration for the TV show. This town can get weird at times. Never this weird, though. You need to bypass the damaged control box.
What am I, an electrician? Hold on.
Yep. Clicky click.
Ah, Sam! That's smart!
Good job, Wade. Okay, stick close. Our first stop is the town hall. The keys to the chopper are there.
See if there's something over here. Woohoo, a flare, yay. Okay, Sarah, let's see. Thank you. nothing to pick up over here.
Over here, Wake! The chopper's in the other direction!
Yeah, yeah, I'm coming, coming, coming. Jeez, boy. Let's have a little look around. Come flying this time. Okay, is that it? So let's see if there's anything down here. Flares. Okay. Sit that way. Can we get in here? More ammo.
I'm gonna want explanation, you know. For example, what the hell happened?
The same thing I think happened to me after I arrived.
During this week, you can't remember?
Oh, I remember now.
Let's see if there's anything back here. Still can't get inside, okay. Yet another manuscript page. Barry in the sheriff's station.
Barry was in his element. Making calls, making things happen, even if he didn't entirely know what those things were. He wouldn't let the hot sheriff chick down. Even if every noise he heard from outside, and he heard plenty, made him jump. He had only paused to text Al a message, told him to hurry up. Suddenly, Barry froze in mid-dial. A window broke somewhere in the building, and then the lights went out.
Okay. Load back to our pistol and switch up our flashlight real quick and let's move on. Let's see anything in here. Thank you.
this light!
I have a key. Watch my back, Wade.
It's an ambush!
Pick it up everything, but we can at least pick some up. More flares, that's good. Can't get inside here. Nope.
Okay, someone's messed with the fuse box here. But you should be able to jury-rig it while I find the keys.
I already got electrocuted once today. How about I look for the keys and you get burned for a change?
Fine. They should be in the clerk's office on the other side of the building, near the main entrance.
Gotcha.
Mm-hmm. Another manuscript page.
The message was from Barry. He was getting worried at the station. He wanted us to hurry. The darkness that wore Barbara Jagger's face was furious. The story in the manuscript had been making it stronger all the time, but now the light had set the writer free and hurt it, weakened it. It was only a matter of days before the dark presence would be strong again, but meanwhile, it would be difficult to recapture the writer.
Okay. It's pretty good. No. Yes, please, lantern.
Okay, Sheriff, I got the keys.
Flashbangs, that was nice.
Barry?
Why isn't he inside?
Oh God! Oh God!
Barry! Look out! Barry, move! Ah! Barry!
He made it inside, Wake. He's okay. The storefront's blocked. Come on, Wake, let's go around. We can meet him in the back.
Okay. Could use a flashbang there, but let's save it.
We can make it through the bookstore. Wheeler should be waiting for us in the backyard.
Get the hell down, or I'll call the sheriff.
Oh, hi, Doc. I've got it. Don't worry about it.
Sarah, about time somebody showed up. All the shooting in the air is idiotic. One of these days, they'll kill somebody. And over Deerfest.
I know. Go back to bed. He's got a point, Wade. Look, this town can't take this.
It's me they want. The sooner I get out of here, the sooner you can all get back to life as usual.
I hope you're right. Come on, let me get this door open.
Wait, you got the keys to the bookstore?
Perks of being the sheriff. A girl needs to get around.
Okay.
They're really taking advantage of your presence here, Wake. I heard they're selling a lot of your Alex Casey books.
Right now, I'm not a big fan of my own writing.
Cynthia's
work. Cynthia Weaver worked hard, following her obsessive rituals, sometimes fighting them, always giving into them in the end. She haunted the halls of Bright Falls' abandoned power plant. She marked her caches with light-sensitive paint that could only be seen by eyes that had been touched by darkness and saved by light like she'd been. She was preparing defenses and supply lines for the war she knew would come. The war between the forces of light and darkness.
Okay. Let's do a quick visit upstairs. Let's see. Should have done this at the police station. Okay. Nothing of interest.
I don't see Barry.
Look, wait, maybe that's him. That's the way to the chopper.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what we can find in here now. There we go. Thank you. see. Usually when all this happens, and it usually means something is gonna go down in a bit.
Howard a piece of my mind about this lock. I told him to get it fixed.
Physical labor. Let's take a break.
All went for me. Well, we survived that one at least.
Let's go, Wade.
Sloppily made. Focus.
We keep them lit all night long on the night before your feast.
Why?
Well, it's tradition.
Okay. Another manuscript, and the Dark Presence hunts Wake.
For it to be free, the Dark Presence needed the writer to finish the story. Again and again, the story let it get frustratingly close to the writer without letting it capture him. It was bound by the events depicted in the manuscript, but it could pursue the writer indirectly, put others on the task, and stop those who would help him. It took over everything in its path, made them its puppets, and sent them after Alan Wake.
Mm-hmm.
We're almost there. We'll have to go through the basement to get to the parking lot.
Yeah, there's no way going through the crypt will turn out to be a bad idea.
Right there.
Mm-hmm. Interesting path.
Anymore.
What are the Christmas lights for?
Protection, man. Like garlic against vampires.
Vampires.
The helicopter's just across the park. Hill, come on.
World. See this headlamp? It's like a superpower. I can just look at one of those things and they die. It's my flaming eye of Mordor. I wish I didn't say that.
Hey, I want a headlamp. Bastard.
Alice had screamed until she had no voice left to scream. Around her, the darkness was alive. It was cold and wet and malevolent and without end. She was a prisoner. Trapped in the dark place. The terror would have burned her mind out, but one thing made her hang on. She could sense Alan in the dark. She could hear him. She could see the words he was writing as flickering shadows. He sensed her too. He was trying to work his way to her.
Mm-hmm. Nice, we have flare gun. I forgot about that. It's an insta-kill.
Someone throws a damn school bus at your head and you're about to take a helicopter ride with someone who may or may not have a pilot's license. You're cleared for the...
Wee-hee! Doing good, Barry.
I'll need a while to prep for takeoff.
Oh, of course you need some time for that. Flashbang. Batteries we don't need. Let's get up everything we can before the shit hits the fan. That's all to say. And time for combat, I guess.
Thank you.
shit. Get into the shopper.
You better put an end to this.
Just get me to Weaver, Sheriff.
You're taking a big chance on a local crazy lady, Al. I hope you're right about her, or we can kiss this town goodbye.
Full of ammo. Yay, my football team won tonight.
had to do something about the chain for the door to open.
Ammo. That was it. Yep. Now we can get inside them. Get into the light and darkness. Where's her face? Okay. Pretty much heal up and all. Yeah. Yep. Sometimes. Hello, turn on.
And here's a new song from a band that they always remind me of rock legends. Don't tell me what this is, just
here's. Oh, come on, I'm stuck. Thank you for that one. Oh my, come on, what the. That's bullshit.
And here's a new song from a band that they always remind me of our local rock legends, the old gods. I couldn't tell you why. I guess it's just, you know, one of those things.
I can't done. Jesus. That was a close call. Well, we have no flares, nothing. That was it there.
The power plant glowed in the night. It was close, but I had to find a way across.
Okay. Check over here first. Woohoo, one flare, one flashbang. But then nothing. Okay. Well, that went nicely. Oh, come on, I ducked that one, damn it. Bullshit. BS. Up, Cynthia on her way to the dam.
Through the water pipe alone, Cynthia was angry at the writer. Foolish young man, taking unnecessary risks. And the way he broke the rules. Didn't he understand what was at stake? Since the terrible days in the 70s, she hadn't wavered once, as hard as it had been. She was tired of protecting the town all these long years, and now only wanted to rest.
Okay, it's gonna be a little bit iffy. Come on. Ah. Up on the roof we go. There's a chair, okay. And a lot of beer cans.
The story I had written in the cabin had come true. Touched by the dark presence, I had written a horror story. But the end was still missing. The story was incomplete, and the last unfinished page of the manuscript still sat in the typewriter in the cabin study. If I could get back there, if I could read the page, then I could write my own ending to this story and save Alice.
Checkpoint. Okay. Nothing. No. Batteries, freaking ammo, yes please. Not the quickest bridge, was it? What the heck? Oh, it doesn't stop. Oh, it's... This is gonna be interesting. Barely made it. We have, yeah, we have that. Nice, more ammo, perfect. Another TV episode then.
Are we men dreaming of being butterflies, or butterflies that dream of being men? Such philosophical concerns are by necessity abstract. And yet, some of us can find concrete proof of the nature of our existence. Tonight's episode, An Absence of Creativity.
Hello, Martha. What did you want to show me?
Oh, Lydia, thank God you're here. Please, it's in the basement.
Woo! those. Okay. So I can shoot one big guy out. It was nothing down here. No. Seems to be something. Ah, nice. Some good stuff to have. Flashbangs and nice, and got three of them. Good. You can kill three big guys pretty much instantly. There, but okay. Too late to do anything about it now.
I recognize the logo on the power plant sign. I'd seen a version of it painted all over the area, signifying hidden caches of supplies.
Safe haven.
Weaver, Cynthia, I'm a friend.
Prove it!
You knew Zane, Thomas Zane. You're the Lady of the Light in the song. You can help me.
About time. Young man, I've been waiting a very long time for you.
Okay, woman. Stuff here first.
Excuse me?
What do you need? Built the room to keep it safe.
Will it help me find Alice? Will it get me back to the cabin? Fine, let's go. I can get my friends to come back with the helicopter.
Outside. Never at night. That's rule number one. You've been breaking the rules, young man, and where has that gotten us, hmm? No, I have a secret route, a lit route. Something was damaged at the transformer yard. It's drained all the reserve power. Without it, the pipe will go dark. The power to the yard must be cut.
Let me guess. You want me to do it?
Young man, you're the one who likes to break the rules. I can't be outside in the dark. The kill switch is outside.
Well, thank you for that, lady.
Thank you.
sent me to cut the power to the transformer yard. I was willing to do grunt work for her to get her to help me. I hoped Weaver was dependable. I'd stumbled into this crazy world a little over a week ago. She had been living this insanity for decades.
No hidden cash around there. Doesn't look like it. Okay, darkness waits in my dream. Big guys, rule number one, never go out at night. Well, you're breaking that rule. Okay.
I could see the kill switch that would cut the power to the transformer yard. Now I had to find a way to reach it.
On. Sounds like a good roulette.
Who designs these things?
No! Oh, come on. What the heck, man?
Who designs these things? Transformer yard went dark and dead. Weaver's water pipe passage should now be good to go.
Bam! die from that. A flare gun, I guess. Kill him instantly. That mean crazy woman.
When she had the accident. And then Tom started writing and woke the darkness up. He tried to bring her back, but you can't do that. There are no free rides like that.
I'm starting to realize that.
In that case, you... looked like her. But it wasn't. Barbara was sweet. He didn't understand until it was too late. He tried to undo it, wrote himself, her, everything he'd ever written out of the world. Oh, he was so famous. And afterward, no one knew. Oh, Tom. He left only one thing behind in my care, in case it happened again. Insurance. He trusted me. Or perhaps used. Tom knew how I felt. Knew I wouldn't refuse him. I built the well-lit room and put it there. It's been waiting for you. We are characters trapped in a story, you have, and none of us will survive. The darkness isn't stopped. She'll twist the story to...
How do you know all this?
Tom, that's the way he wrote it. He still talks to me in television. Both been touched by the darkness, young man. He saved us both from light. The darkness is with you. You sustain.
Staying in my mind aware, huh?
This pipe will take us directly to the well-lit room.
Okay, I need to call my friends, tell them where we're going.
Hello? Ow!
Barry, we're headed to the dam in one of the pipes. Meet us there. It's Sarah now?
Whoa! No! Sweet love of...
Barry! Barry! We gotta go see if they're okay.
They're probably dead. You must reach the well-lit room. This is no time to be a selfish idiot.
That's my best friend!
Well, be a fool. I'll use the pipe. I'll meet you at the dam if you make it.
At least I didn't have to worry about her. She knew how to stay safe.
Up. No. Oh, come on. Stuck on a stupid log.
Sarah was almost starting to relax. Maybe they could turn this into a win yet. Suddenly,
There was a piercing sound, like a table saw gone wild, as 100 birds made out of shadows swarmed into the rotor. The chopper bucked wildly and the board lit up, telling her what she already knew. They were going down. Barry Wheeler screamed next to her.
You go, Barry. Birds. Damn, it takes a long time to charge this up. Come on. Thank you.
Baker! Sarah!
The crash site looked bad, but as far as I could tell, the wreck was empty.
And the Sundance Kid.
I have a different ending in mind.
Yeah, I'm fine. Thanks for asking.
I knew you'd be all right.
How's that?
The Flaming Eye of Mordor?
Laugh it up, funny man. Didn't we have somewhere to go?
Weaver will meet us at the dam.
Safe in the light.
Oh, sure.
You see those lights? That's the elevator we need to take. Open.
Checkpoint.
Oh, sweet pool of light.
Wake, call the elevator. I'm keeping watch.
I think I hear something moving around.
Just hold on.
Ah, come.
It's here! Ow! Let's go!
Why couldn't you press the damn button? I was a little bit busy.
There's an entrance into the dam at the top. What's the plan, Wade?
Well, Weaver's crazy, but she's got something Zane left behind. Something to fix this.
Gee, could you be a little more vague?
Seriously? Might as well be Paul Bunyan or Bigfoot.
Yeah, well, he was real.
Let's be careful, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, jeez, I hate this.
Okay, so you guys are leaving me outside then, huh? Zane's shoebox.
Thomas
box,
Zane
huh?
knew he had to remove all that had made this horror possible, including himself. That was the only way to banish the dark presence he had unleashed and now looked at him through the eyes of his dead love. But he also knew that despite his best efforts, it might someday return. So even as he wrote himself and his work out of existence, he added a loophole as insurance, an exception to the rule. Anything of his stored in a shoebox would remain.
Okay. Let there be light to stand in. Okay. Checkpoint. Up we go.
This can be a hobby or a job.
I was ridiculously outnumbered. The searchlight could even the odds.
Ah.
entertaining chorus. Barry, the optimist.
There's an old army base at Raincove Point, north of here. It was active during the Second World War. They operated here back then. They must have built this.
Yes, they did. It's my place now. Six, 33, and 118 need changing soon, and I don't want to climb up the ladder to change them because it's very late, and I'm tired. And if you take it, I won't have to do that anymore.
The page was autobiographical, a memory from my childhood. But I didn't write this. It was a page written by Thomas Zane. None of them were supposed to exist anymore.
Alan, 7 years old, would fight sleep to the bitter end. When he did sleep, he soon woke up, screaming, the nightmares fresh in his mind. One evening, his mother, sitting by his bed, offered him an old light switch. She called it the clicker, and flicking the switch would turn on a magical light that would drive the beast away. To imbue the talisman with all possible power, she added that it had been given to her by Alan's father. Alan never knew him, and anything of his took on mythical proportions in his mind. With the clicker firmly in his hand, Alan finally slept like a baby. Now, almost 30 years later, Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
My mind swirled. I'd given the clicker to Alice, yet it was here. Zane had written it into existence in a story I had written. I can get to her now. I can finish this.
Okay, so that's end of episode 5 then.